Hey guys, welcome back to Construction Simulator 2015 with me, Brad M73. How you doing, guys? We're back for the next job. What? I'm getting like 90 frames a second. Oh, there are 50s. I was like looking up this way and I was getting like 90 frames a second. I was like, whoa. let's get started. Hopefully you guys have been doing pretty good. Hopefully better than I have been. I've been all right, but something kind of weird happened the other day, and this is probably going to gross some of you out, and then some of you guys are not even going to know what I'm talking about, maybe. I don't know. I freaking passed a kidney stone the other day. I had, like, no clue. I've had a couple kidney stones in the past, and usually they're, like, insanely painful, but I've been having back pains, which I have been telling you guys about, maybe. And I think that might be what caused that. So let's go ahead. We're going to start off. We're going to take this stadium pool job, and we're going to need to talk to the foreman and excavate some stuff. But I'm not going to do any of the excavation. I'm going to use my hired worker to do that. You guys always ask, like, don't you have hired workers? And I don't use them enough, so we're going to do that. I guess we're going to have to find the foreman. I don't know if he's up here or not. So, yeah, I passed a freaking kidney stone. I was just like, something doesn't feel quite right. And next thing I know, a kidney stone. And I was just like, thank gosh that's over with. So I don't have to worry about back pain anymore. So yeah, like a week or two ago, I can't remember exactly when it was, but I'd say within the last 2 weeks, maybe even 3 weeks, I'd been having some pretty bad back pain. And first of all, I need to figure out where I'm going. Where is the job site? Sawmill nursery. Wall factory. Where? I'm at a loss. Like, where is the... Where's the foreman? I don't know where the foreman is. Uh-oh, there's a mosquito flying around my house. I had my door open earlier tonight. And, I guess a mosquito must have got in here. Home base, peeling material. Okay. Let's see. Let's close this. No. Let's go to the large excavator in case the foreman is up here somewhere. Wait a second here. Hold on. Jobs. Active job. What the heck? Didn't I accept that? Okay. Oh, maybe I didn't click accept contract. Now we'll accept the contract. So, yeah, I had some back pain, and now I'm pretty much convinced that that's most likely what had caused the back pain. So good news is that's over with, very surprisingly, and I don't know why this is sitting like this or where my trailer is, but I would have sworn the last save I took this back to the factory, didn't I? Or to the the home base. That's weird. excuse me. Alright, so let's go back to the flatbed truck with trailer, because I think that's probably where flatbed truck with crane. Oh, now I see the foreman. He's over there. So, yeah, I'm just so relieved that you know, I was able to pass the stupid thing without, you know, any complications or any massive pain, anything like that. And because trust me, I've had a couple in the past, and they were absolutely excruciating. So if you don't know what a kidney stone is, Google it or something and be grossed out, because it's not pleasant. The head of the building department just called me. We got the job. We have to build the new swimming pool. It will be located right beside the stadium, so it will be called the stadium pool. That's fantastic. I assume the mayor himself has recommended us based on personal experience, but I'm sure this wasn't the only reason. At least we have a lot of experience. That's true. At this point, we have done almost everything there is to do. Oh no, the game's going to be over soon. Okay, I'll get in contact with you. All right. So, yeah, we have to go out here to the sports park. All right. Let's get on the road, I guess. In other news, let's see. On Friday, I've got my next 3 months for my Millennium Falcon build, which is I'm super excited about. I've already started on some of the episodes, so I'm probably going to be rolling those out over the course of the next week or so. So if you guys enjoy those, you know, if you want to see, you know, actual construction simulator or construction reality, you know, definitely check out that series, because I'm going to be building stuff and it's going to be super cool. And I don't know where I'm going. Oh my gosh. I'm so glad we don't have damage on this. So we're going to drive out to the job site. We're going to hire a worker. And we're going to see what all needs to be done. I'm actually getting a pretty, you know, pretty darn smooth frame rate, though. Which is pretty nice, considering, you know, it used to drop down pretty... Oh, gosh. Used to drop down pretty low when we were in the city, so doesn't really seem to be doing that right now. All right. Oh, this is where the expressway ends, or highway, or Autobahn, since we're in Germany, I'm assuming, or Austria. Or maybe it's Switzerland. No, I think we're supposed to be in Germany, I think. Because we're Ausfahrting there. So if you want to actually see me construct something for real, you might enjoy the series. I don't know. But it's pretty cool, because I've been assembling some of the frame parts already, and the framing is just amazing. I mean, it's huge, and it's gonna. I just from what I've got built right now, it's just incredible how big this thing's gonna be. So it's gonna be a lot of fun. It is a lot of fun. It's really relaxing too. You know, it allows me to kind of step, you know, away from the computer, and actually build something real. You know, do something real instead of, you know, staring at a computer screen. You know, all evening or whatnot. So in that respect, it's pretty nice. I can do something that's not computer related. And I've actually I used to build models all the time as a kid, you know, teenager, you know, probably up into my early 20s. I used to build model kits and things like that, and always really enjoyed that and had fun doing it. So kind of going back to my roots in that respect. And so if you want to see me build some models, then check out that series. Let's see, what else is going on? Oh, I also, Excalibur Publishing sent me a game. It's kind of it's a small game, nothing like too major. It's called, and actually it's really cheap. I think it's only like $5 or $6. It's pretty inexpensive. I think it's called, what is it called? Better Late Than Dead, I think is what it is. And it's some type of survival type game, and I really can't figure out too much more than that at this point. All right, so I'm assuming that if we were actually going to dig this, I think we're actually going to have to dig this out, and then this, and then this, and this, and probably this whole thing. So we're going to go ahead. I'm going to hire a worker. And we're going to do that right there. Whoa, this worker takes 15 minutes and 45 seconds, and you cannot do anything on the construction site during this time. Oh my gosh. Well, that kind of sucks. Well, I guess in the meantime, let's go ahead and pick up another job because we're going to need it. Let's see, what's a good one? Ooh, I saw an 800 large apartment building. We could do that one. We could do a mansion, which is going to use a couple different things. I think when I get up to about $2 million, I am going to buy the large mobile crane, which I think is what we need to do these houses. That's the mod. Let's do the mansion. So now, guys, we're going to have two jobs going on at the same time. And let's just jump into the roller here. And I'm going to teleport this to construction site number two, which is going to be this. So, where are we? Oh, I was like, isn't this supposed to be where the mayor's mansion is? But no, it's actually down there. There you can see the tennis court we built, and isn't there supposed to be a pool down there? There's that pool, but that's not the one I remember building. Oh no, it's the one back here. Wait, there was just a house up here. Oh, so now the mansion isn't there, and now we have to build it. Dun, dun, dun. Whoa. Okay. So, okay, compression is on. We're just gonna compress this worksite. Be all done with it. So yeah, back to what is that game called? Better Late Than Dead. Yeah, it's some kind of it's just a really inexpensive game. I think it's actually made by the same people that did, or the same studio that did Enforcer, Police Crime Action, or whatever that one was called. It's been a long time since I played it, and I know some of you guys have actually asked me to continue playing that game, but it's really not a fun gaming experience. I had thought about it. I was really hoping that the guys would continue with development, but it's just not really turning out that way that they're, you know, continuing development. So I decided to stop. I know. At least as far as I know, it's not been in development. I don't think I have it installed on my new PC, actually. I'll have to look, but I thought I installed it, but I don't know. Maybe I didn't. I don't think that I have it installed, though. And I don't think I uninstalled it on this computer, because right around that, you know, I used to game on my old laptop, and I get a lot of people that ask me questions, you know, can you game on a laptop? And yeah, you can. There's actually some really awesome gaming laptops out there. If you don't want to spend a ton of money and you want a really good gaming experience, I highly recommend the Asus G51. I think it's the G51 or G52 series. Or I think they have a new one. It's like the 751 or something like that. You'd have to go and look at their websites, because now that I have a new desktop, I haven't really been shopping around or looking at PCs that much. I tend to help people who have questions about PCs more than I worry about my own stuff. So that's kind of nice because it helps me. If somebody has a question about building a new PC, I can help them out and say, oh, this is going to be compatible, or you might want to think about an SSD, or something along those lines. And I actually have fun doing that. So, you guys ask questions, and I'm always here to help. I always try to help you guys out when I can. Nothing makes me sadder than seeing somebody buy a PC that's just not up to snuff, and then they're disappointed with their gaming experience. And when you really get a good gaming PC, it's kind of like a transcendent experience. Playing a game, right now I'm at, around 70 frames a second playing this game, which is, more than 60 frames a second. And there are people out there that are like, well, you can't tell the difference between, 60 and 70 frames a second. And I guarantee you that if you get a monitor that can push more than 60 frames a second, you can definitely tell. Definitely. No doubt in my mind. Because I can tell. And especially when you play games at even higher frame rates, upwards of like 100 and to 120, 140 frames a second, you can really tell then. All right, so we have this done. Clear the roller, so we'll clear that out. And we'll see what happens. Oh, gosh. All right, so now we need our concrete mixer. And so up here at the top right, you can actually see the two different job sites. So here we can see, so they've already excavated, they've got 100% of the earth moved, and so now the phase is being completed by a worker. Stage three, hello, is going to be excavate more. So all this is, all that mission really is going to be doing is just tons of excavating. All right, so let's get in our concrete pump. And then in the interest of saving time, we're going to go ahead and teleport. Well, it's not really teleporting. It's just that it's like you're telling a worker, hey, take the truck up to the construction site for me. That's what we've got workers for, right? Oh, look, and we've got the excavator right there, too. So we're going to go ahead and pull this out. Gonna hit, whoops. No, that's not going to work. I'm going to have to move up a little bit more. Actually, I can just, oh no, I didn't mean to do that. Actually, what if I just pulled him right up here? Is it going to let me do it here? That would be really good if it did. Because then the rotation point right here is going to be in the, in the right position to do that. I should have left the pipe in there. Whoops. And we're out. Okay. So we're going to need the concrete mixer truck. And we'll go ahead. We'll do the same thing. Have him drive up to the construction site for us. Thank you very much. Okay, so we'll get the the concrete mix pouring in there. And hopefully that is going to... Yep. Okay. Okay. So we're just going to fill up this area with concrete. I'm keeping an eye on the other work, the other job site. Oh man, I didn't mean to do that. Okay. Uh-oh. Kind of got to go a little bit slower. Let all the concrete spread out there. We missed a little bit up there. I think this would be fun in real life to like run a concrete mixing truck. It's something about the way the concrete just oozes all over the place. I don't know. I just think it would be kind of fun. Seriously, oh. I'm like, why can't it come in any farther? Can I drag it in? Oh gosh. This is not turning out as expected. We're gonna have to kind of drag like a semicircle around. Because I'm pretty sure that's gonna be as close in as we're gonna be able to get. Should be getting a notification that we can clear the work site here pretty soon, I would think. Unless I did something to turn off the notifications, which I don't think I did. Oh, there we go. Fill it up. There we go. I guess we might as well just do these corners up here. Change my camera angle here a little bit. It's actually easier doing it from that that other perspective, though, because then you have a... quite a different... this is easier to control, I guess. Like this. Right? Okay, now it's telling us to do that. So let's go ahead. And the last little bit there will be filled in. Run over and get in the concrete truck and move it out of the way. Yep, there we go. All right, so now we're going to need to get these... we have to take the crane truck to the material handler. All right, in the meantime, though, I want to go over to the construction site here. Okay. So, yeah. Oh, look at this. It's got... this all dug out. It's almost like they did it with the front, like a different type of digger. Interesting. All right, so let's go back. Let's go to the next stage. And we're going to hire another worker to do that one. So yeah, I was right. You know, we're going to have to do this one, and then there's going to be probably six sections, I would guess. So flatbed truck with crane. Okay, so we're up here. Let's go over to the building materials dealer in the village. Yeah. And we'll buy all of our stuff here since it's right down the road. I can't jump there. Oh, there we go. All right, so we need some small clay bricks. Need those. We need bags of concrete. Okay. I don't remember those trucks being there before. I don't know. Maybe they were. Okay. So get this put up here. Awesome. Okay. Cargo fastened. Yeah, I always try to get that cargo fastened because if you don't, it could go flipping off your truck and it can be kind of a pain to pick up again. Okay. We are doing good. I think I've definitely gotten better with the forklift. Okay. Uh-oh. Or not. I don't know. I say I'm doing pretty good. Not doing too bad. Cargo fastened. Okay, so this will be the last one for this side. If I can get it on here properly. Go away, mosquito. You're not wanted here. Why is it when a mosquito flies in my house, it always, like, follows me around? They have, like, heat-sensing vision, I think, or something, so they know where you are. Okay, we'll put these guys over on this side. Oh, perfect. Just where I wanted my camera to go. Nope, I want to lower it. Like so. All right. Now that this mosquito is flying around, I keep feeling like there's insects crawling on me, which there probably are, who knows. Okay. All right. And I can just back the forklift up right there. Put the forks down for safety, I guess, maybe. I would think that that would be safer. And we'll attach the cargo. And hit Y. That'll fold up the... things there, and back we go to the mansion, I guess. And getting a nice solid 74 frames a second. Oh, I'm concentrating on driving. I wish they had music in this game. Or maybe they do. Maybe I turn the music off. I don't know. Okay. Now my friend. Well, no, I'm still around 80 frames a second up here. That's good. Okay, I'm pretty sure I have to make a left here. I don't know why. The game just seems to be performing a lot better in this episode. I don't remember seeing any patches come through on Steam lately, though. So I don't know why they would be performing differently. Yeah, I'm getting 77. It was just up to 82 there. Now it's down to 70. Now it's up to 88. See, they need to put a guardrail there. Okay. So we'll set up the truck here. Get out and unfasten the cargo. Here we are. And actually, let me get my controller out because I can do this much faster with the controller. At least I think I can do it much faster. Okay. We're gonna have to check on the swimming pool after this. No, in. And down. Last but not least, not quite last, we will have some bricks here to offload. Okay. All right, now the cement mix, and we'll be done with this stage. And now, last but not least...
last but not most.
Why do they say last but not least? Well, okay. It's like you're the last person, but not the least person. Kind of a thing. I think it's done to be polite, which a lot of people don't do anymore. Unfortunately. Oh gosh, what just happened? Okay, it looks like we're going to be pouring some more concrete here, so... In the meantime... Okay, so he's almost finished over there. So, let's see here. Why don't I... have Scotty beam me over to the... Wait. I'm already there.
You should think about purchasing a new vehicle. Oh, should I know?
I want to see if this will just magically... I want to see if my... I'm going to stand on here and I'm going to see if my guy falls into the hole.
Will you fall into the hole?
Let's see, stage four, pour concrete. Man, this is a lot of stages too. Got more bricks, more concrete. Insulation material, put more concrete. Some beams and roofing tiles, big roofing tiles. Oh no, we're gonna have to call in the excavation team on this job. Let's look at this one. Stage 3, 95% complete. Come on, get to 100, 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 get to 100. Am I annoying you yet? Everybody's unsubscribing now. Come on, get to 100, get to 100, get to 100, get to 100. I'm annoying me right now, so... Okay, 97...
Okay.
I'm going to take a nap. It's late. No, I'm not really sleepy. I'm not really sleepy. Oh, no, it's 99%. I'm scared. Oh, my gosh. Oh, that scared me a little bit. All right. Next up. Rebar from a materials trade dealer. Then excavate. Okay. So let's get an R. Let's see here. You know, well, flatbed truck with crane. All right, so we're gonna drive him over to the materials dealer, right? Purchase the rebar. What? We mean the holding area is not large enough for this purchase. Oh crap, these aren't their big rebar frames, are they? Let me move this forward some. I'm a bit afraid that this might not. Let's try two. Yep.
It is what I was afraid of.
However, I should be able to actually let's move up just a little bit. There we go. I should be able to stack these up on the truck so that I can stack all four of them on here. And let's go ahead and fold the doors up here. Okay, again, let's go. Go out with you. Bring these guys, bring this one in. Whoops. Gonna work. Want it out there. Okay. All right, I'm gonna see if I can set the next one like right next to that. I don't know if I'm gonna be able to though. But we'll see if my skill can get it in there. Oh yeah, look at that. Look at them apples. Oh yeah. All right, no problem, guys. All right, steel elements, two more rebar. Because we need four, right? Four rebar, yes. I wish those menus would close out when you hit the escape button because that would seem logical to me, but what do I know? You know what I mean? Maybe there is a reason that the developers didn't do it that way. I don't know. Okay. Now, I'm gonna have to get out and strap this load down before I retract everything because when you do the backspace reset, the load has a tendency to jump sometimes. Uh-oh. Here we go. All right, so I'm gonna just jump out, attach that cargo really quick. Now I can just backspace that. And retract the little feet there. We will be all set to go. Why am I clicking? There we go. Thought I might have had one of the turn signals on, but it didn't look like I did. I don't know, guys. This guy's going to pull out in front of me. Oh, my gosh. Oh, my gosh. That was close. We missed that fence by a few pixels, I'm sure. Okay. So we'll unload these, and then we'll go and do the concrete. We'll pour the concrete on the next level of the mansion, and then we'll probably actually be done for this episode. Okay. Oh, whoops, I need to detach the cargo. Wait, did I detach it? It said cargo detached. Yeah, I guess I did. Okay. There we go. Okay. So this will be done in just a moment. I'm going to assume that we're putting in the... Hello. Okay. Okay, excavate the marked area. All right, so there's going to be some more excavation there. All right, so we're... Let's see here. All right, hire a worker. And yes, this next part is definitely going to need to be the last bit we do. So let's go to the concrete pump. Oh, whoops. Okay. I'll fold that out just yet. We just want to retract the arm around. Turning as we go. Actually, I think, well, I don't know. We'll see what happens here. Gonna make it there? Oh, come on. Darn you, Xbox controller. You always do that to me. There we go. This actually seems to go a lot faster with the Xbox controller, oddly enough. All right, let's hello. Let's say hello. No. Let's not and say we did. All right, so that part. Daggone mosquito, he's driving me nuts. All right, away we go. Oh, let's go out this way. Oh, now we need to go in. Yeah, I mean, it seemed like when I'm using the Xbox controller, it just seems like this part, like the concrete's spreading out more quickly than when I was using the keyboard before. I kind of, for some reason, forgot about the Xbox controller. I missed a spot. I have to go There we go. Monthly statement. There's $65,000 down the tubes. Whoops. And just a little, there we go. Oh, we're almost out at full length, guys. Why is this not coming in? What's going on here? Oh. That's going that way. That's going this way. That's left and right. Huh, that's weird. It's like the arm is locked into this one position here. Yeah, it's left and right. Oh gosh, that scared me. Okay, so stadium pool is completed. What's going on here? Oh, there we go. Now we're pulling it back in. Yay! There we go. Clear the con. No, I don't want to clear it. I want to get it all done. Phew. Oh. Yay, we're done. All right. So. Alright, guys, well, that is going to wrap it up for this episode. So we'll see you back next week when we continue these two jobs. Hopefully, we'll be able to finish. If not, we won't, obviously. And I appreciate you guys, you know, joining me for another episode. As always, please do not forget to hit that like button and share my videos. Helps me out tremendously. You have no idea. We just passed 16,300 subscribers. I want to say we're close to 16,350 already in just like 1 week. I haven't really looked. Actually, I can check really quick if you guys want me to. Oh, you do? Okay. Let's see here. We are at 16,000. Oh my gosh, exactly 16,360. So thank you guys so much. I'm glad you're enjoying the series, and we'll see you back next time for more Construction Simulator 2015. So again, if you haven't subscribed, subscribe now. I am BradM73. We'll see you next time. Bye for now, guys.